What's that? What's the epithet?
The love charm.
What are they? Filled with sweet or something? What are they made from?
I'm not 100% sure.
Still 100% sure?
No. This
milk powder, sugar, ghee, nectar.
What are you doing? This year?
Cooking gulab jamun. Just rolling around. Left evenly. The world famous ISKCON preparation for gulab jamuns. ISKCON bullets. Papa in the early days used to keep them on in a big jar in the storefront.
What's in here?
That's the whey. She just made some curd and some fresh milk. That's just the whey. The curd has been separated from the whey, and that's what he's hanging up back there.
They got sound?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good. This is a sweet rice for the feast.
Yeah, that's
the best sweet rice you'll ever taste.
That's it.
Don't look too closely. Hey, you guys. On the camera there.
Here we go. Here we go.
Here we go.
He should be down the ring.
Well, he closed up the arch there. Hey, arch. Close up here.
My back to put him in too.
What's up, Dad?
International banquet here today. Just chopping up the sweet and sour. They're making the French all night time. Wholemeal samosas here. South Indian sweet rice. Australian water.
Is that too short?
Yeah, too short. Too wide. I guess excuse me for a second camera. I've got to get back to the crew here.
This is making the samosas. This is how you stitch them up. A little water around the edge of the pastry, pinch them together, and that's how we close them off. Voila! Samosa, ready for the cooking. I'm not ready for the cooking.
Oh, sorry.
Just giving him a black eye. Nervously pacing.
And back again.
Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Ram, Krishna, Krishna.
Had a really good time here. Thanks very much. Take care.
Is it filming? I think they're in love.
Am I filming?
Hello. Come in, dear. Come in.
Give us a little tour.
Come in.
This is a Hare Krishna kitchen, food for life kitchen, preparing all these wonderful things. This is Conrad, the blender machine.
How goes it? Think everything will be ready?
Yeah.
Listen to that?
Yeah. No problems. Chris is in control. All the devotees are sincere. And you're here. Alright, so make sure you all come hungry, people. We're cooking enough for an army.
Priya.
Yes. And that will be it. Yep. Why do you have to
Are you coming to it?
Nothing inside, huh?
Huh?
Nothing.
You remain steady in his meditation on the transcendental self. So that's actually it's described that one. I'll show you what it says here. But the one who has conquered the mind, the struggle of the mind, the super soul is already reached, for he has attained tranquility. Such a person, happiness and distress, he will hold on to the same. So in other words, one who is established in the reduction of self-realization, he understands that he is worthy of being and stands as well. That person is satisfied by the virtue of the five modes of realization. In other words, we're happy with some few things, because our realization is so small, we haven't done that much realization. The one who is spiritually realized, actually, he's not concerned about the trivialities of the tribal life. Rather, he's interested in establishing himself within the self. See what I'm saying? So it's described as an absolute slave here, that as an absolute person, that's a lot of steady in his meditations. So the perfection of meditation is actually characterized by the ability to see the self, by the mind. Exactly. To relish, actually to rejoice within the self. Not only to control it by meditating, but actually relish, to understand. When you understand yourself, just like if you're doing a puzzle or something and you get it right, you feel satisfied. So imagine what it's like when one understands the meaning. You feel really happy and very satisfied and very, very peaceful. So one should engage in yoga with determination, but not be devious in the mind. Gradually, step by step, one becomes fixed in trance or meditation by conviction, by intelligence, and by using the mind as a correct way to model. Yoga and meditation is a mind that you can follow. So this is a very, very beautiful book, and very spiritual book.
Thank you.
It's not that anyone's going to grab anything, but just...
No.
Whatever's in that bag,
that's
enough.
You're right then.
Thank you very much.
Is it any day for this video?
Anytime.
Anytime, any place, anywhere.
Yeah, you'll pop it up there too.
Yeah.
How many frequencies are there? So that's one part of it, to enjoy, to relish a very nice vegetarian feast. But the most important thing would be, as I said, to introduce ourselves to the community and to inform them a little bit about our food for life activities. So without further ado, I would like to invite the Lord Mayor of Newcastle, Alderman John McNaughton, to speak some words of his realisations on our food for life and the service which we provide to the community. So I'd like everyone to hear about it.
Thank you, Paul. Ladies and gentlemen, in accepting this invitation to come along tonight, I was very impressed with the Hare Krishna movement and their service to the community. They are very dedicated people, and we see them around the place. We know of their existence, but we don't know very much about what they do. And when they came to me to explain their program, it was really something that impressed me with their dedication, their voluntary work, and their keen interest in doing something for our community. So I welcome the opportunity to be here, to be part of this release in the Hunter region. I commend them for the work that they are doing and propose to do. And of course, it is very special in their care for diet, and seeing that people are not simply fed, but fed in a very, very nourishing way. I don't know whether they need to do any proselytising work to attract people to their particular group or not. I don't think they'll have much success with people that they're talking to by way of assisting homeless young people and so on. But the fact that they are caring people who are keenly interested in helping those people, just the fact, that fact alone, helps those people to know that they are cared for. Is a very, very real problem in our city and our region. The problem of homelessness, of all ages, but particularly homeless youth, is one that in itself is not that big. There are not that many of them. And we could certainly say, well, it's tough to walk away from it. That is not acceptable in our community these days. We've made a decision as a community that that is not acceptable. We are going to do something about the problem. And the Hare Krishnas are doing something about it. They're part of that movement. And the thing that really impresses me with them is their caring attitude to what they do. And that in itself is a great benefit to the community and to the people they're looking after. I wish them well.
So, we would like also to introduce the president of the Hare Krishna Food for Life in the Hunter Valley, Mr. John Howery. Just speak a little bit about the history of Food for Life, and also our plans for the Hunter Valley region, in particular our mobile kitchen and our free food kitchen in Newcastle area. So please welcome John Howery. It certainly is encouraging when the chief figure of our city here in Newcastle can speak so highly of our simple work. It is a natural thing for devotees, for servants of God, to care for others. So Hare Krishna Food for Life is an extension of that natural compassion. It is an offering of kindness to those in need. And we feel we try to present a human face to the charity work that we do. I might if I may to read a short quotation from an interview with the Reverend Ted Noss, founder of the Wayside Chapel in Sydney. A couple of years ago, Ted Noss had this to say about the Hare Krishna Food for Life project. The vast amounts of meals the Hare Krishna Food for Life serve, what the government would have to do to feed these hungry people. The work would be enormous. I think the money they save the community is valued at hundreds of thousands of dollars. It's not only their food, and that's very important, but there is also fellowship, and it's given in a charitable and in a friendly way. It's not like a docu, and it's not like a handout, which is often impersonal and doesn't have any appeal to it. I think that programs like the Hare Krishna Food for Life are invaluable, and not only invaluable, but absolutely necessary to deal with the kind of harshness in our society today. So this harshness in our modern society, the Lord Mayor briefly mentioned this point of homelessness. I think that it's reflected by this very prominent aspect of our social system at this time. Although it appears to be in a small number, it is a real issue, because there are many people who are actually termed as homeless. They may have a place to stay, they may have a roof over their heads, but there is far more to that term, homelessness. It reflects on a society of insecurity. Many people in our community don't have adequate food, they don't have adequate clothing, or possibly shelter, but most of all, there is a great need for genuine love and care. And that is what Hare Krishna Food for Life has to offer. We are offering genuine consideration and care for those in need. Now, we've briefly spoken about our food. The Hare Krishna people are very famous for our food, and I'd like to ask actually for a show of hands of those who have come this evening without having their dinner. Could we please have a show of hands? Right. That means I have about 5 more minutes if I'm lucky. There might be a raid on the kitchen at the bank. The Hare Krishna food is food with a difference. It's not ordinary food. We've all heard that we are, or you are what you eat. So this is true. What we eat has an effect on us. So good nourishing food that is also prepared with love and devotion has a tremendous effect to nourish the body and also give vital energy to the soul and to the self. So the food that we prepare is prepared in that way. It's offered to God with love and devotion, and we will present that you will be able to taste the difference when you actually taste that food, which is prepared in a loving way. Now, a little of the history of Food for Life. The most caring person that I know of and that I've experienced in my life was my spiritual master, His Divine Grace, who is pictured here. His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada, the founder of the Hare Krishna movement and the inspiration for the Food for Life project. In 1972 in Calcutta, Srila Prabhupada was looking out of his window, and outside he saw two young village children scavenging through the garbage looking for something to eat. When he saw that, he turned to his disciples and he said, "This should never happen, especially within a 10-mile radius of any Hare Krishna establishment." So from that time, the volunteer workers of Hare Krishna Food for Life have worked to establish food distribution centers wherever there is a need throughout the world. We have now come to the Hunter Valley region, and since moving to our farm project in Millfield, near Cessnock, many government and welfare agencies have encouraged us that you should continue this good work that you've been doing in the King's Cross area of Sydney, specifically, or mainly. Throughout the world, Hare Krishna Food for Life has distributed 50 million meals. In Australia, some 4 months ago, we distributed the 2 millionth meal at our drop-in centre in King's Cross. And thank you. I was going to say that these are significant figures. They're substantial amounts of food that are being distributed to people in need. And currently, over 200 meals are served nightly in that King's Cross drop-in centre. So, there are three main reasons for asking everyone to come tonight. Paul has already mentioned the first one, that was to introduce ourselves to the people of Newcastle and the Hunter Valley. The second one was to give a little more information about Hare Krishna Food for Life. And the third one was to involve everyone in our plans for... Now, our motto for the region is called Feeding the Hungry and the Hunter. We had all sorts of debates on finding the right name. We had Hungry Hunters and we had all sorts of things. But we finalized Feeding the Hungry and the Hunter. So two main objectives before us now is to establish a mobile food kitchen to travel far and wide in the Hunter region. There are many accessible, relatively accessible areas. So we want to travel to those areas and hold programs food distribution. And also we'd like to establish a distribution center here in Newcastle. So those are, I would think, worthwhile projects. I'd like to ask everyone if they feel that those are worthwhile projects and they feel that Hare Krishna Food for Life is a genuine program benefiting the community. If you do think that, I would like to ask you to raise your hand if you think these are worthwhile projects. Okay, I appreciate that. I'd like to thank everyone in closing for coming here this evening. We really appreciate your support. It's not easy sometimes to cross over the cultural barriers that may seem to be there, but when you cross over them and you see that behind this sort of short haircut, a shaven head, and paint on the nose, you'll find just an average person like you and many others who is needing, as we've discussed, security. And that security means loving, caring, kindness. So that is Hare Krishna Food for Life. So this evening we want to share a little of that kindness with you in the form of a 10-course international menu. We hope everyone will be very satisfied and will be happy with Hare Krishna Food for Life in the Hunter region. Thank you very much. tonight we have, as John said, about 10 preparations. It's an international menu. We have sweet and sour, or Chinese style, sweet and sour with fresh cheese. We have a Spanish salad, or Mediterranean salad actually. We have a French burratini pastry. We have a South Indian rice with nuts and peas. We have some poppadoms. Now those poppadoms are like chips. You make funny noises with that. We have an English semolina Italian orange pudding. We have about 60 litres of vanilla rice pudding. We have a carob fudge with crushed nuts on top. I think it's about 500 pieces. Everybody gets one when they leave, but you can have something to drink this week. We have, you always miss, a fruit punch drink. We have, a big cake right in front of me. The Hare Krishna Food for Life fruit cake. And we also have, what else is that?
Oh, it's gulab jamun. What's a gulab jamun? You'll get an experience when you have a gulab jamun. A gulab jamun is a Hare Krishna bomb. Because when they go down to the stomach, it just explodes. They're sweet dumplings. What they have, they're made from milk powder and flour. They're rolled very carefully so there's no cracks. Then we fry them for about 25 minutes in pure butter or ghee, right? So they swell up. They go three times the size. Then, when we drain them, we put them in sugar syrup and we soak them for about 4 hours. So we have, is any diabetics out there? They're a sponge ball, so when you have these, they explode in your mouth, or they explode in your mouth, but they're fine. I love them all. So there's about, what, 700 of those, I think? So there's plenty of food. So that's coming up very soon, so hang on. But in the meanwhile, I'd like to introduce to you, you all know him very well, a very good friend of mine, and a really good friend of Newcastle people. I met him about a month ago, and I didn't actually know who he was, because I'm from Sydney. I met him in his toy shop. I didn't know who he was, it was just Hubert. And I started talking to him about our cookbook. I was actually taking around some cookbooks, raising some funds for our cookbook. And he was very interested in the cookbook. And then I, somehow or other, we just got talking about food and then Food for Life. And then I told him about the Food for Life mission, and he was very, very inspired by the Food for Life mission. And so inspired that he was happy to come along tonight to be a part of this, to do a few tricky things, and to speak a little bit on his realizations about Food for Life. So without further ado, Super Yubert.
Hello everybody. Come on, I'm a real friendly person.
Hello.
Well, we'll try that again, alright? Hello everybody.
Hello.
Good, that's good. Well, actually, the reason I think I'm here, I was invited because Paul saw me in my Superman costume, you see, and he thought, that guy needs a feed. I think you're in very good hands here. These people are extremely friendly and kind people. And to get you all in a mood like they are, a real friendly mood, I'd like you all to turn to the person next to you. Look at them in the eyes. Come on, we're going to be like a Christian. Look at them in the eyes and say, hello, sexy lips. Their Food for Life appears to be a fantastic idea. All these people want to do is help other people. And I think they've come to a really good community here in Newcastle and other areas. They've already found that the people up here are friendlier, a bit friendlier than other places. The telethon's proved that, the way we can outdo a national telethon just with a local one. And they've found that the people up here are very friendly, so thank you very much for coming tonight and showing you we want to be friends with you people too. Not truly like no. The kindness that they have shown me just in a couple of months has been unbelievable. They've been feeding me up their food and it is beautiful. So we're in for a real treat tonight. Now, I've also got a football here signed by all the Newcastle Knights. They were going to come here tonight, but they sprung a meeting of some kind. Annual players meeting for that. So if you'd like a football, a Knights football with all their autographs on it, we'll auction that up. Oh. Anyway, Not only cookbooks, great cookbooks. Yeah, I said it. It was a good start. Same thing here. Oh, actually, I'll tell you a true story about this. It's a true story. Doing a lot of travelling, I was going with a couple of other comedians up at Townsville, and we would work together for months. We worked together for years, actually. We were real good friends. We took off on an Ansett plane. The three of us, I got the aisle seat for a reason. I thought I'd play a trick on them. I took the book I was playing with. This is true. We took off Ansett. What do you do when the first thing you get in the air? They come out and hand me out magazines, don't they? Hello, you want a magazine to read? And I'll tell you, I was real nervous sitting there when they got to me. I said, no, man, I'm right off the book here. Well, I can tell you, no sense of humour there, but. And for a lot of keeping, I had to sit on my book at the end to prevent them. They're kind of food for life. It's going to be really good for this, the whole area. Their aim is to set up one in Newcastle, Lake Macquarie and Cessnock area. So anybody who just cannot afford food and a living outfit will end up going to these people. You'll know where their centres are. And they will look after you because they're really friendly people. So I hope you all have a really good time tonight. Now, would anybody like a nice football? Really? Yeah. So, everyone got something?
Yeah, football.
Right. $50?
Yeah.
Right. Anybody want $50? Remember, this goes to the Hare Krishna group, Tom. 70, do I get 70? For a nice football. Autograph by all the knights. 70, 65? Go once? Twice? So. Would you all like a really huge
form of that?
Honourable John, the Mayor of Newcastle, John McDonald, the generosity of this man, and you realise he works 7 days a week for going to all things like this, a very generous man. Love you, you're a big man.
David and Kathleen from Nestles donated 50 kilograms of condensed milk and 50 kilograms of milk. That was from one phone call. Carl Meissen from Combined Packaging donated 1,000 plates, 1,000 spoons, and 1,000 models. Graham from GPAC also donated 500 plates and spoons. And the lawyers, you see here, are from care of Waterway, and the lady who donated those spoons from care of all those tissues, serviettes that you're going to be using later were donated by Dolan. And all the printing was donated by Mike and Tim of Rawlins Publications. Paul Murray from the Builders donated all the flour and all the semolina we needed. And all the smelly flowers, they were donated by Ken Johnson from the Agricultural College, Lindy from White Forest, Danella from Jimmy's Gallery, Marion from Civic Studio Flores, and that's it. And Helen from Hunter Health was donated 10 kilograms of plants, and Super Duper.
And Nat Jeffrey and Chris Barr and Lord Mayor, we're all going to serve you dinner tonight. Oh, we're going to cut the cake now. You go to lunch. You can see this is the launching of Food for Life in the Harbour. This is your actually attending the launching and then meeting it probably permanently. I'll say it again.
Put your hands together for a large round of applause for Paul, who's known to us as Priya Brandon. He's been the main force behind this, and also all the volunteers. Hare Krishna Food for Life, life workers that are working for this together.
Everybody.
Yeah, everybody. You're going to say Hare Krishna.
Yeah, well, I'll tell them that's where it's going to be. Okay. We thought we'd be led up into the bed.
Oh, no, you've got to work first.
You're right there.
Thanks very much.
Hey,
bebop?
Oh, no.
Come on, man. No?
I couldn't.
Sure.
I wouldn't know how to.
Everyone got well fed. Who's that for?